everyone. So welcome to the new series of Atomic Structure. Here we shall be discussing some important concepts and the theory in it along with the questions. The first video is the basic video where I shall be dealing with the distance of closest approach and all that stuff. I have begun my mathematics series on Unacademy also. You can watch it for free. I have placed the link in the description. Before beginning with the distance of closest approach, try to understand two concepts: that the formula of kinetic energy is given by half into mass into velocity square, and the force is equal to K into Q1 into Q2 by R square in the electrostatic terms, where what is K? K is defined as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1 is the charge of the atom 1 or whatever the compound 1 we are taking. The Q2 is the second one, and R is the distance between these two. Okay, now let us try to understand that what is the potential energy in the electrostatic terms. The force is given by minus du by dr. For now it is actually minus del u by del r, but for now it is minus du by dr, that is sufficient. So from here we know that we need to derive u, where u is the potential energy. Okay, so F is equal to what? K into Q1 into Q2 by R square. It will be equal to minus du by dr. Okay, further we multiply dr here, so what I get? K into Q1 into Q2 into dr by R square is equal to minus du. Okay, now what we do is that we have to integrate both these sides. We can understand very carefully that K, Q1 and Q2 will be constants, because K is already a constant. You can see Q1 and Q2 are the charges, which obviously will be a constant. Okay, so we are integrating both these sides, and this is a constant, so it can be taken out of the integration from here. So from here we get, let us integrate it. Before that, try to understand a simple thing in electrostatics, that potential energy at infinity is assumed to be equal to zero. Okay, so this is the important thing which is assumed while solving the potential energy questions. It cannot also be assumed, so that can be a very good question where they give you that u at infinity is equal to some let me say 2 units or 3 units or something, that kind of thing can be mentioned. But here we take u at infinity to be equal to zero. Okay, so let us begin from here. If we begin from any r is equal to r, okay, so at that point, let me say that the potential energy of that system is equal to some u. Okay, now we move on till r is equal to infinity or r tends to infinity. At that point, we have the potential energy is equal to zero. So we have put on the limits. See, try not to cram anything. This is the 11th class. You have to not cram anything in the 11th and the 12th and the droppers. Otherwise, you will definitely face many problems in the main examination, which happens. So from here, we integrated. Now what is the integration of dr by r square? Integration r raised to power minus 2 into dr basically. Okay, so from here we get r raised to power minus 2 plus 1 upon minus 2 plus 1, which is equal to minus 1 by r. Okay, so we put the value here. So k into q1 into q2 into minus 1 by r, the range, so the limit goes on from r to infinity is equal to minus du. What is the integration of du? That will be equal to u. Okay, moving on from u to infinity, and the minus sign which is already placed outside. Now u to zero. Now let us put on the limits here. So k, q1, q2, the minus sign is taken out from here. We get 1 by r, so it becomes 1 by infinity minus 1 by r, which will be equal to minus of, we put the values here, so 0 minus u. Okay, so from here further we get minus q, k, q1, q2 into 1 by infinity is equal to 0, because 1 by infinity, because constant by any infinity term is equal to 0, and here we get minus 1 by r, which will be equal to u. So this minus and minus gets here, and we get the value of potential energy in the electrostatic terms to be equal to k, q1, q2 by r. So this thing will be very useful in the entire physics. We have taken only minus du by dr here. It can be minus du by dx, minus du by dy, minus du by dz also for the three-dimensional geometry. So force is kq1 q2 by r square, and u is equal to kq1 q2 by r. So let us try to understand that what is the meaning of distance of closest approach. So here we have been given an alpha particle. Alpha particle is basically a set of two protons and two neutrons. So this is an alpha particle here. This is another nucleus which we have taken, which has a charge Ze. So basically both of these have the same charge here. Okay, now what we do is that we throw this alpha particle with some velocity v. Basically we throw this towards the this another particle which is given to us, which has z into e charge. Okay, so we have thrown this with some initial velocity v, let me say v. Okay, now we need to find that, see, both of these, since both of these have the same charges, thus what will happen, these both will repel each other at a particular position. So this move on, this moves on till a particular distance, till here, let me say, and then starts moving back from here. Okay, because then the repulsion will be very strong and thus it will start moving back from here. Our mission is to find this distance. So this, let me say, is the capital distance r. Okay, and initially we assume that the distance between these two is equal to some small r. Our mission is to find this capital R so that we can get the distance of the closest approach. Okay, so the basic laws of energy conservation are applied here. Let us try to see that what are the energy conservation laws. This position is said to be some A, this position is said to be some B. Okay, now let us try to write the energy at the point A. So energy at the point A will be equal to what? See, energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. There is no non-conservative force. So we only potential energy plus kinetic energy will be written here. Okay, so what is the potential energy? I've already told you the potential energy is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R. So we write potential energy as K into Q1. What is the charge of this? That is equal to 2E into Q2. That is equal to some ZE upon the distance between these two is equal to R plus the kinetic energy. What is the kinetic energy? That is half mv square. So half into m into v square. Now since this particle is at rest, so we don't need to write any kinetic energy for here. So that term is already ignored. Now let us see for the position B. So energy at the point B is equal to, once again, potential energy plus kinetic energy. Okay, so what is the potential energy at this position? I'm sorry, the B position will be somewhat here. So we have to find the at this position B. So you can see that at here, this position, the potential energy will be equal to what? K into Q1 is equal to 2E into Q2, that is equal to ZE upon. Now what is the closest distance between them? That is equal to R plus half into m into v square. Now what is the velocity at this position? See, I hope some people would have studied kinematics here. So when you throw a particle above, that is in the air, in the towards the positive y axis direction basically, then it goes on to a particular height and then returns back towards the earth because of gravity. Okay, now at this point, the highest point, the velocity of the particle is equal to zero. The similar position is applied here, that the particle would momentarily stop here and then start moving back. So here at point B, the velocity will be equal to zero. Okay, so we have got energy of A to be, energy at the point A to be equal to somewhat this, energy of point B to be equal to this, where this term is equal to zero. Now what will happen, since energy is conserved in nature, this is a non-dissipative field, so what will happen, the energy at the point A will be equal to energy at the point B. So what is energy at the point A? Energy at the point A is equal to K into, so we can write 2K ZE square upon R plus half mv square, which will be equal to 2k ze square upon capital R plus 0. Now once again, making an important assumption here. So what is the assumption here? That we throw this particle initially from R is equal to infinity. So what I mean to say is that this particle is thrown from some r is equal to infinity with a particular speed, then it moves here and then comes back to a particular point. So if r tends to infinity here, then what happens? See, r tends to infinity. I hope many students are 11th class, so I am writing r is equal to infinity. So r tends to infinity here. So this thing will be equal to what? Something upon infinity, which will equal to zero. Okay, I hope the point is understood. See, I am deriving everything. Nothing should be crammed. That is my major mission. So half into m into v square is equal to 2kze square upon r. Let me move on to the next page. So we have derived this expression here. Now we need to find the distance r. So from here we get the value of r to be equal to, this thing is multiplied here, so 4kze square upon mv square. Okay, now our mission was to find out the distance r only, because that is the distance of closest approach which can occur between the two things which are given to us. Now the most important point here is that which many people get confused, m is equal to mass of alpha particle. Okay, don't get confused ki m is the mass of this or m is the mass of this. M is the mass of the alpha particle. As you can see, initially we have taken the kinetic energy for this one. Okay, so this is how you find out the distance of closest approach. Now let us discuss something about the Thompson model. First of all, let us try to understand that what is the meaning of the Thompson model. J.J. Thompson stated that we have the atom described as follows. First of all, what I want you people to imagine is that you take a watermelon, which is somewhat like this. Okay, cut it from the middle. And this watermelon is now placed in this position and you are seen from above. Okay, so you are seeing just from above a particular projection that is equal to circle. So it's just seeing the above part from here. That is the projection of which is equal to a circle. So this thing I'm showing here enlarged. So what he stated that whenever we have an atom, the negative charge is distributed. This is a watermelon. So the negative charge is distributed as the seeds here. You can see the black seeds which are there. So the negative charge is distributed as the black seeds which is present, and the positive charge is all together present as the red part inside this watermelon type model. Okay, so once again, what the negative charge is, the electrons, those are basically the black seeds, okay, which are the negative charge or the electrons, and the positive charge is spread across the watermelon as the red juicy part, I can say. So this is the positive part. So this is also known as the watermelon model, or commonly known as the plum pudding model. Okay, because in pudding also you can see that these type of structures are present. So plum pudding model or the watermelon model, it states that this is a watermelon here which consists of the equal distribution, because this has to be uniform distribution. Let me also write that point. It is a uniform distribution, otherwise the charge won't be balanced, okay, and there would be instability. So there is a uniform distribution of the seeds, that is the negative charge, and the red juicy part, which is the positive charge. So this is the J.J. Thompson model. Now this was the video one regarding the atomic structure, where we discussed the distance of closest approach and J.J. Thompson model. In the next video, we shall be discussing about the discovery of electrons, protons, neutrons, and the Rutherford model. Okay, so I hope that this video has taught you something new. So if there are any doubts, you can definitely ask me in the comment section. Okay, you can check me out on Unacademy, where I've already discussed the entire organic chemistry and I've started mathematics. So go follow me there. And if there are any doubts, you can definitely ask me. And best of luck to all of you. Thank you.